advantage against Houston. We are off and running.
Maya Mangalyu, number 1111 for Boston, going up against number 101, Smooth Operator. Smooth Operator trapped behind a scrum start from Boston. Just an impenetrable mass of blue skaters. Tampa, of course, in the hot pink, and Boston in the dark blue. But Smooth Operator gets up to the front, gets around Vixen to hit you, and claims lead jammer for Tampa in the first jam. Maya Mangalyu still is being drawn back as 101 Smooth Operator gets into the back on a scoring pass. Once again, runs into Vixen to hit you and gets out. Grand slam for Tampa.
First Bulldog.
Space Invader number 1978 fights her way past all four of the Tampa skaters. Picks up lead jammer along the way. The pack at full strength, 4-on-4, but we still on a power jam. A little bit breaker, got sent to the penalty box in the previous jam, and now Space Invader negotiating her way through the pack and completes her first scoring pass. And guess what? It's a grand slam. She got the jammer point.
The call was a direction of gameplay, which is going to send the Tampa blocker to the back. This time, Boston gets through untouched, Bulldog.
That's right. That's Betty Krueger, number 78, in the penalty box for Tampa. So 4-on-3 pack right now. A little bit breaker on her initial pass. Space Invader moving in, gets tip checked by Black Jack. Backed up by Laren and Pupcake. Dodges around Pupcake, but gets through the pack. Did not get the jammer lap points. That's right, little bit breaker. Got out just in time as the jam is called off.
We have our first lead change of the game for you. Bulldog, we almost didn't see it coming. Boston, sneaky, strong, coming back to take it at 43-42.
And you're absolutely right, and that is much more interesting than not getting the jammer lap point. You are absolutely right, Maxie Hats. Smooth Operator, number 101, jamming for Tampa. She didn't. That was the pivot. Now she gets knocked to the outside, picks herself back up. At the back of the pack, moving through the back. There's Lil Wayne dodging around Lil A, but gets caught by... that is Alley Cat Scratch. That was the first big move I've seen from Alley Cat Scratch, but that was a nice one. Smooth Operator up front, still on her initial pass. Shayna Nestor gets knocked out of the way, but Smooth Operator taken out by Bad Person. There's Lil Payne coming around, but doesn't get in time. Jam gets called off.
Lil Payne showing her stuff there. She expected a couple of points out of that one, I believe. But normally a very clean skater, unlike her, to get through and first and not be lead. But again, Boston holding to that 1-point lead, 43-42. And it's the Flying King on the jam line for Boston against Breezy for Miami.
Tampa Bay,
my bad, sorry.
Breezy at the back of the pack, muscled out by Shark Week, and there we go. Flying King around the track. She is lead jammer and probably got the jammer lap point. Breezy just not able to even get into the pack. The double team of Maya Mangalyu and Shark Week just holding her at the back of the pack and keep knocking her out of bounds. Here comes Flying King, already got the grand slam. Coming around again. Pupcake going to the penalty box for Tampa, so they're down on the blocker again. Flying King into the pack on a second scoring pass. Excuse me, that's Betty Krueger. Betty Krueger going to the penalty box. That's because Pupcake's still on the track. It's 95-46 is Pupcake. Flying King coming through a second grand slam for Boston.
Boston extending the lead now, 53-42, and an untouched scoring pass, the high five for Flying King.
All right, well, you know, Boston moved through so many jammers. I guess they found the rotation they like, and Flying King certainly proving it right now. Flying King coming through again, but gets a cutting the track. That means it's going to be a power jam for Tampa. Breezy finally getting out of her initial pass, and now on her first scoring pass, runs right into Maya Mangalyu and Anorexia, but Anorexia stumbles, and Breezy able to get through, and guess what? Gets the grand slam, including the jammer point. So many grand slams in this game, and you know the way they say natural grand slam. You know, although right now we are on a power jam, but most of these grand slams have been natural. We haven't had a lot of power jams, but Breezy knocked out of bounds, has to recycle all the way back to turn four, now runs right into Maya Mangalyu. She's back, Maya Mangalyu backed up by Shark Week and Anorexia, and they muscle her out of bounds. She was shuffled off the Buffalo, but gets back Kagan comes through clean, and another grand slam for Tampa.
Maya Mangley, you had to sit down during that last scrum. Breezy, will she get another scoring pass? The answer is no. The Jam had timed out. Boston's penalty problems, though, continuing. This one is a 58-52 bout right now, and all of a sudden, though, Betty Krueger for Tampa has picked up her second and third trips to the box, and a little bit breaker with two trips as well. Boy, both of these teams are leaving nothing on the track. Bulldog.
PhD still jamming for Tampa, but only two blockers on the track to get through. She gets past Vixen to hit you and Crazy Dukes. Now Ginger Kidd coming out of the penalty box. She was standing up at the start of the jam, and now it's now Boston up to three skaters. But PH Diesel in the back and makes short work of the back, gets around Crazy Dukes, number five for Boston, and picks up, guess what? A grand slam. The pack now moving as Flying King for Boston comes out of the penalty box, so Boston has their jammer back. But here comes PH Diesel on a second scoring pass, moves up the inside. Ginger Kid comes across with a hip check, but PH Diesel dodges behind it, but Crazy Dukes backs her up, but can't reel her back in. It's another grand slam for Tampa Bay. Here's Flying King still in the pack, trying to complete her initial pass, gets screened out by Lil A. Lily the Kid, number 138. Lily the Kid and Lil A look so much alike, and they almost have the same pants. So don't go by the pants. Flying King tries to fly out of the pack, but ends up getting knocked to the infield and has to recycle out of turn three. And here comes PH Diesel for yet another scoring pass. Gets around that three wall, picks up another grand slam.
For those of you who enjoy lead changes, of course, we have another one in favor of Tampa.
Star pass for on Boston. Flying King passing the star to Maya Mangley, who gets out of the pack in short work. PH Diesel, though, knocked to the infield and slow getting up. She was up on one knee. I don't know if she was breathing hard or what, but she calls off the jam from the infield.
Tampa taking control, 76-58, and that star pass was crucial for Boston to stop the bleeding. They just could not get the jammer through. Maya Mangley made short work of it, as you said, Bulldog, but Tampa's defense right now is the story of this bout. They are making it very, very difficult for Boston.
Lily the Kid all by herself in the penalty box. So Boston with a 4-on-3 pack advantage. Smooth operator number 101 going up against Space Invader number 1978. Space Invader up the outside lane. Smooth operator was just behind her, but she got knocked down by Haley Contagious, number 103F for Boston. But Space Invader doing a complete split and does not go out of bounds, but does not claim lead jammer. She got a no pass, no penalty. So the opportunity's still there for Smooth Operator to get out, but she gets stuck behind Anorexia, and Dixie Kicks cannot get into the pack and muscled out to the infield as Space Invader gets into the pack on her first scoring pass. We're up to the front, stopped by Blackjack and Betty Krueger, but finally gets her way free, fights her way free. Smooth Operator now finally completing her initial pass, gets lead jammer, calls it off immediately, but 5 points for Boston.
They need those five, takes them up to 68. They are within 10 of Boston now. Neither team using a timeout so far. They might want them in the second period. We've got 2 minutes, 34 seconds left in this first period, and Coach Justin is heading out to talk to the referees right now. He is a wily one. Sometimes I wonder, Bulldog, whether he's simply trying to maybe get his players a little bit of a breather right now. These last couple of jams have been quite exhausting for the Boston Massacre.
Oh, the pack action in this bout has been unbelievable. It has been every single step of the way. The pack, even when there is no jammer in the pack, the pack has been just a meat grinder in there. Everyone jockeying for position, everyone fighting for every single inch of territory on the track. These teams have come here and they are fighting tooth and nail for the spots. And the thing is, neither one of them is really in any danger at this time. and particularly unless there's a huge blowout in this game, which does not look like there's going to be at this point, there's probably not going to be much shifting. At best, maybe they might swap places in the Division One. But, you would, right so far in this game, you would think they're fighting for the championships right here tonight.
They're excited to be here, both of these teams. Well, this is as close to championship play as you're going to find, Bulldog. Where else do you have leagues from all over the world coming on one weekend to participate in such high-level derby with such a knowledgeable and excited crowd? And you can see in the stands, we have a full house here on track number 3 for Tampa and Boston. And if once again, we want to let you know, if you're at home and you have any questions, give us a call, give us a shout-out at hashtag WFTDA.TV. The Wicked Skatewear official timeout has officially ended now, Bulldog, and we are back to action.
Number 22, Breezy, lining up for Tampa. Tampa in the hot pink, and she is... Lil Payne jamming for Boston. Lil Payne, number 451, jamming for Boston. Bursts free and gets lead jammer. Now we got Breezy stuck behind a three-wall. Gets a big shoulder from Vixen to hit you, but just brushes it off. Shakes it off, but now Ginger Kid coming in with a hip check. Still holding her back. Now both of those skaters holding back Breezy on her initial pass as Lil Payne gets into the back on a scoring pass. But she is shoved up against a four-wall from Tampa. That's Lil A, number 90, Tic Tac Tony, and Lunch Lady, and Lily the Kid, I believe, is the fourth player. But now Lil Payne completing that scoring pass, gets 5 points. Looking back to her bench, she might call it off. She probably should call it off because Breezy was getting awfully close to the peck.
And she indeed does. And the trend continues, Bulldog. 5 at a time for both of these teams. Kind of surprising the scores aren't multiples of 5 right now. Tampa holding on to that 8-point lead, 76-68 right now. But Lil Payne, sneakily effective. You look at a skater like Lil Payne and you don't see the flash. You don't see the really quick strides or anything like that, but boy, she is so strong and has such good balance.
Apollo Anna jamming for Tampa Bay against Maya Mangalyu. Maya Mangalyu knocked to the infield, has to recycle Pupcake, drawing her almost back to turn 4 before Maya Mangalyu can get back in. But Apollo Anna going to the penalty box, looks like a cutting the track on the Tampa Bay jammer, and that means it's a power jam for Maya Mangalyu, who is also in control of the clock with lead jammer as she casually moves into the, or possibly cautiously moves into the Tampa Bay defense. The Boston moving into the passive offense formation. Where they stand in a line in turn 1, but Maya Mangalyu fights her way past the Tampa Bay defense, picking up a grand slam. And now the pack is still motionless, but a four wall lined up at the top of turn 1, but it is unable to stop her. Blackjack, number 21 for Tampa, made a valiant effort, but Maya Mangalyu was able to skate past it. Gets another grand slam, 10 points so far. Third scoring pass, once again running into Pupcake. Dodges around her. Pupcake, number 95, 46 for Tampa. Blackjack in front, but now Maya Mangalyu matching that, cutting the track that Apollo Anna was sent in for. So it looks like we're gonna have a jammer swap. And so we're gonna have a swap power jams, and it's gonna move into Tampa's power jam. Tampa Bay, probably about 40 seconds of my unofficial, mind you, tally, or my inner mental clock. But Apollo Anna, I believe, still on her initial pass. So not going to be matching any of the points that Maya Mangalyu had already gotten. Not yet. But nevertheless, Tampa did a very aggressive play on this power jam. So they're not content to sit back and let Boston beat up on their jammer. That is sometimes an effective tactic. But Apollo Anna running into, just directly into the Boston wall, knocked down, but pops right back up. Such a lot of resilience in this relatively short, smaller, this Tampa team, we were talking about that earlier, this Tampa team is kind of a little bit smaller in general than most of their opponents.
But they're scrappy, Bulldog, and boy, if you told somebody that, yes, you can have 3 points, but you're going to have to get knocked down like Tampa just did, you'd have to question whether it would be worth it. That's what's so wonderful about roller derby. These gals are all willing to take that punishment to pick up those points. Those were three important points for Tampa. They will go into halftime with a one-point lead as a result of that, 79-78. And, boy, stay tuned. Be sure to give us a shout on Twitter at hashtag talk2WFTDA. We are interested in hearing what you have to say about this bout, about ECDX 2013 in general, presented to you, of course, by the Philly Roller Girls. And we got to give the Philly Roller Girls a big shout-out, Bulldog.
And it looks like warming up during the halftime of this bout, warming up is Team USA. It's that's members of the team that played at the World Cup in 2011, the next World Cup. Well, I don't know if we're...
2014 is Dallas for Roller Derby World Cup coming up.
But they're going to be playing against Team Canada, the other World Cup team that represented, Canada in the 2011 World Cup.
And one of the great things about ECDX, as we said, that will be on track number three. Another several good games going on track number two. Thank you for tuning in to WFTDA.TV.
Are you tired of slipping through slippery corners? Fed up with slipping on slippery surfaces? Introducing the Villain from Radar Wheels. Stride confidently through corners without slipping out. The Villain digs and holds through the corners like no other. Grips on even the worst surfaces. But don't take our word for it.
I hate sliding out. The Villains were so grippy, I felt like I was totally in control. The wheels are really grippy. They were really grippy, but they were still so fast.
Skater approved. The Villain and Villain Wide by Radar Wheels. Order now.
We have Lil Bit Breaker, number 365, jamming for Tampa off the bat. And the jammer, Maya Mangalyu, starting out in the penalty box, but standing up almost immediately after the first whistle. So she'll be joining us shortly. But Lil Bit Breaker fighting her way through, claims lead jammer for Tampa.
Mangalyu back on the track, Bulldog.
Maya Mangalyu on her initial pass, just coming out of the penalty box, as you said, gets around Lil A and completes that first scoring, that first initial pass. Lil Bit Breaker running into the pack, runs into Dixie Kicks, calls off the jam.
And she picks up one for her efforts, and boy, Maya Mangalyu doing great work there to force the issue as much as she could. For Boston, looked like Tampa had the opportunity to score more than one on that jam, but they do, and that increases their lead by 100%. It's now 80-78 in favor of Tampa.
They just doubled their lead in one jam. Lil Payne, number 451, immediately making contact with Breezy, number 22, the Tampa Bay's jammer, right off the first whistle. Tampa Bay in the pink, Boston in the dark blue, but Lil Payne fights her way free of the pack for lead jammer. Breezy at the back of the pack gets cleared out by Ginger Kid, but Ginger Kid falls down, and Lil Bit Breaker races to the front of the pack. She's held up by Shayna Nestor for enough time for Lil Payne to get into the pack, and now breaks through, calls off the jam, and we may have a lead change here, Max.
Classic Boston Derby. We do. 82 now for the Boston Massacre. Tampa Tantrums at 80. That is Lil Payne getting through, very collected, very calm, surveying the track. She says, okay, I've got my four. That's it.
But Boston getting two skaters in the penalty box. It's Anorexia and Haley Contagious. So they're going to have that's going to be Tampa with a 4-on-2 pack advantage. Once again, the penalty is working against Boston. Space Invader, number 1978, jamming for Boston. Muscled to the side by Lily the Kid, but Space Invader fights her way forward and gets out first. P.H. Diesel still in the pack, even though they have twice as many blockers on the track, but fights her way, finds an inside lane, but there goes Space Invader on her first scoring pass, running in, slipping right past Little A, and Lunch Later slowing her down, but Space Invader dodging around her, completes a scoring pass for 4 points, but there goes P.H. Diesel looking to match those Crazy Dukes, number five, slowing her down, but P.H. Diesel able to get through and matches those 4 points, but here comes Space Invader on her second scoring pass. Slips up the inside, gets caught at the front by Lunch Lady, but she dodges past. But right behind her, PH Diesel, neck and neck, and they're matching point for point so far, Max.
And no lead jammer, or so we thought. It may be that Space Invader is not aware of her lead status. She did get through first, but we're going to go the full 2 minutes, it would appear.
Yeah, PH Diesel and Space Invader both knocked down right at the end of the jam time.
And four more points for Boston, though. Boston taking an early lead in this second period now, 94 to 88. And it almost appears as though Boston has done better offensively when they have fewer blockers on the track. If that makes sense, Bulldog, I'm not sure it does.
And not only did they flip the lead, but right also they flipped the pack advantage. Now Tampa, two blockers in the hole. Boston at full strength. Shark Week jamming and slips through easily against this overmatched pack. Apollo Anna has her hands full, fighting four Boston attackers with only two blockers to assist her. She's still at the back of the pack. Lois Carmen Dominator in the middle of a three wall. Ginger Kid on the inside and Bad Person on the outside. But Shark Week slipping through the jammer for Boston and gets a grand slam. Apollo Anna still behind that same three wall, and she's getting knocked around. Now Daisy Kicks moving in to help out with that three wall, but somehow Apollo Anna finding a tiny little opening and gets through, but only completing her initial pass. Already a full lap behind, Shark Week on her second scoring pass calls it off.
She picks up one, and that was two very different passes, scoring passes for Shark Week. She wasn't even touched her first time through, and the second time through she got hit three times by each Tampa blocker. It's all of a sudden like they realized that, wait a second, we've got to keep this thing in check. Boston showing their stuff. They are now sitting on 100, Tampa with 88. We expected a low scoring bout, and actually there's a little more points on the board at this point than maybe one would have expected if history means anything, Bulldog. Last time these two teams met, it was actually a Tampa win, but it was 86-80 for the final. So, when these two teams get together, it's a lot of intense derby. We have time out called for an official review now, it appears, by Boston.
Now, I don't think it is an official review. That's what it looked like, too, briefly. But actually, the head ref moved over to the Boston bench. If it's an official review, we would have seen Tampa join in, but we didn't see that. So, no, it looks like it wasn't an official review, just the head ref straightening something out. And impossible to tell. It looks like a little false start on the, well, the whistle was blown, but it was indicating that the official timeout was over. Now, it looks like Anorexia went to the penalty box, so that means it's going to be even in the pack. It looked like it was going to start out 4-on-3 Boston advantage, but now it's 3-on-3, even Steven in the pack. And there goes a little pain, dodging right around Lily the Kid, and gets out of the pack first for lead jammer, and it's going to be a power jam. Smooth operator heading to the penalty box, number 101, the jammer for Tampa.
Called on a track cut. The previous penalty was an illegal procedure call. Now we have vintage Little Pain. She doesn't have the stride of a fast skater, but she's got the speed of a fast skater, Bulldog. It's really amazing and very deceptive. I think defenders look at Little Pain sometimes and they think that, we're going to be able to hold her off, but she keeps her arms down. until that time when she's, that's what we mean. Lil Payne is able to draw the penalty there, and she continues to roll five at a time. Boston on a run to start the second period of this one, Bulldog.
That's right, Lil A against Lil Payne, and neither one of those skaters probably used to getting called a high, on a high block, but Lil A went to the penalty box, and now Lil Payne sent to the penalty box. It looks, well, the only explanation that there should be is that Smooth Operator actually got 2 minutes. So that means that Lil Payne got waved off of the penalty box, and Smooth Operator's penalty was reduced by a minute. And that means there she goes. She's coming right back in. Anorexia for Boston following her. Lil Payne, though, completing that scoring pass, getting past Lunch Lady, and it's a grand slam. But now Smooth Operator is battering her away, hurtling through the back, but gets taken down by Maya Mangalyu and Crazy Dukes. Picks herself back up, but runs into all four of the Boston blockers. Now Maya Mangalyu with a hip check, taking Smooth Operator to the inside, and Lil Payne on a scoring pass, but leaning into that two wall. Lily the Kid and Tic Tac Tony slowing her down, but Lil Payne sliding into the infield, and as she calls, no, she didn't call off the jam. Timed out.
Lil Payne holding her hands up in victory and doing a little happy dance there. Boy, what an amazing bit of defensive enthusiasm on the part of Boston right there. Crazy Dukes and Maya Mangalyu, when they saw the jammer come back for Tampa, just put down the clamps. They said, you are not getting through.
Yeah, that's right. Tampa Bay so dominant in the first half, but now Boston on a bit of a scoring streak. Little bit breaker, number 365, jamming for Tampa Bay. But Flying King up to the front, a three wall in the front. That is Betty Krueger, Blackjack, and Laren Kill. But it slips through and almost goes out of bounds, but just manages to ride the line through that pack and stays in bounds and gets lead jammer. That's Flying King of Boston. But there goes Little Bit Breaker racing around the track to try and catch up to the Boston jammer, but Flying King stumbles over Blackjack and calls off the jam from her knees, picking up three for Boston.
3 points for Flying King, and she was flying into turn number four right there. Unbelievable balance. When you're at the number 24 and the number 26 team in the WFTDA rankings, all the players down your roster are going to have good skating skills. But Flying King there showed a little more than just good skating skills right there. She showed such track awareness and the ability to keep her feet under her.
Breezy jamming against Space Invader for Boston. Space Invader up to the front. Lil A in her characteristic inverted position, but unable to stay in front of Space Invader, and Space Invader is lead jammer. Breezy still making her way through the track. It's almost knocked out of bounds by Bad Person, but Dixie Kicks and Vixen to Hitcha, managing to form up that two wall. Anorexia coming in with a hip check, taking down Breezy as Space Invader races through the pack almost untouched, and a grand slam for Boston. Breezy still on her initial pass, but still facing that two wall. Dixie Kicks and Vixen to Hitcha repeatedly battering her at the front of the pack. But Breezy finally fighting her way through, but just as Space Invader gets a cutting the track, Max.
That is, turnabout is fair play for Tampa. Tampa needed this desperately as Boston was starting to run away. 127 to 188 right now. The character of this bout so far indicates that Tampa will now be mounting a little bit of a run of their own. They're going on five. Let's see what more Breezy can get.
And this is the biggest advantage that Tampa Bay can get. They have all of their skaters on the track, but Boston down to two. Dixie Kicks trying to reel her back in. But did you see that? That was a squeeze play. Vixen to Hitcha and Dixie Kicks just came together. And Breezy, you could see it on her face, the impact that had. But she just picked herself back up. She is so tough. She is scrappy, like you said, Max. Coming through a second grand slam for Tampa Bay. Boston jammer, Space Invader looking on helplessly from the penalty box, but they still have a healthy lead. Here comes Breezy coming in on a third scoring pass. Bad Person, number 55, screened off by Lunch Lady, but up front, Dixie Kicks and Vixen to Hitcha, forming a solid two-all, and again, repeatedly battering the much shorter Tampa Bay jammer, but Tampa Bay jammer Breezy still getting five more on that last scoring pass.
And the ladies in pink pulling up over 108 right there. Breezy paying for every single point there. But, boy, she got some help from her team in the most important sense, that they were controlling the pack and allowing her to make those passes. It was a tiring scoring run that Breezy just had there. But by maintaining that slower pack speed, she was able to get around.
Timeout called by Boston. First time out of the game, I believe.
Yes. Well, both of these teams, smart and seasoned tournament teams. So absolutely, they're going to be holding their timeouts for when they really matter. And, boy, very clean action so far. Four, however, Lily the Kid now, for Tampa. Still, we mentioned early in the going, Vixen DeHitchia for Boston with those three early penalties, but she's been able to keep it under control ever since then, Bulldog. Anorexia joins the three penalty club for Boston, but again, at this point in the bout with 18:59 left, three penalties you can live with. Four trips to the box, all of a sudden you have to start adjusting your outlook on the game, and that's where Lily the Kid is.
Maya Mangalyu jamming for Boston, number 1111. Boston, of course, in the blue. PH Diesel, number 2, jamming for Tampa. Tampa in the pink. With just under 19 minutes left in the game, the score 129 for Boston, 108 for Tampa. And there's the first whistle starting the jam. PH Diesel immediately running into a scrum of Boston skaters. And there goes Haley Contagious trying to squeeze into the front of them. Join that three wall. Now it's a four wall of Boston. PH Diesel driven to the back of the pack by some vicious shoulder check from Haley Contagious. Maya Mangalyu up front, the jammer for Boston. One-on-one with Betty Krueger, but manages to outskate her. Just dodges, does a little pirouette move right around and gets lead jammer for Boston. PH Diesel driven out of bounds. Has to recycle back out of turn two as Maya Mangalyu into the pack on her first scoring pass. Runs once again into Betty Krueger. Oh, excuse me, that was Alley Cat Scratch. Betty Krueger up front, leaning into Maya Mangalyu, but unable to keep her back, and a grand slam for Boston.
And Boston seems to have figured out the Tampa offense, at least for the time being. Tampa has not achieved lead jammer yet in this second period, but they were Tampa's jam. Oh, we have a jammer penalty, Bulldog. Is that a forearm called on Maya Mangalyu?
That is correct. And now the penalty box is actually full. Only two blockers from each team on the... Oh, but PH Diesel cutting the track, and it's going to be a jammer swap out. I think Maya Mangalyu was only in the penalty box for about 15 seconds or so. So not a very long power jam. Maya Mangalyu looks like she's going to eat up most of that power jam just getting back onto the track.
20 seconds or 23 seconds left on the jam clock, and Boston would just as soon see this jam expire.
Now Maya Mangalyu getting past Laren Kill and Pupcake relatively easily. The pack still at 2-on-2 with Betty Krueger going to the penalty box just as one of her teammates gets out. Maya Mangalyu weaving her way through the Tampa defense. That's Pupcake and Laren Kill. And Maya Mangalyu with a grand slam for Boston, and the time runs out on that jam.
And what did I know? Boston was in a situation where they could have just run out the clock on that jam, but Maya Mangalyu with some alert skating able to pick up 10 more points as the jam expired. We now have four penalties accrued on Betty Krueger as well for Tampa. And what I was saying before we had the jammer penalty issues there, Bulldog, is that Boston has figured out the offense of Tampa to the extent they were really getting positive results. Tampa was in the beginning between turn one and turn number two, the Tampa jammers were taking that outside line and they were able to out-sprint the Boston defenders. But they're no go right now. Boston has figured that out, and Tampa jammers are having a difficult time adjusting to that tactic of Boston.
That's right. So the timeout, the first team timeout taken by Tampa Bay, winding down, getting ready to start up again. Lil Payne, number 451, jamming for Boston. And for Tampa Bay, it's number 3E8, Apollo Anna. Both teams down one blocker, but it looks like Boston's Shark Week fixing to return very shortly, but Apollo Anna stuck behind the three wall of all three Boston blockers. Lil Payne making short work of Lil A and Lily the Kid out front for Tampa. Comes out lead jammer. There comes Apollo Anna taking another run at the Boston defense and gets driven to the infield. Has to recycle again out of turn one as Lil Payne on a scoring pass, running into Lily the Kid, and now Lily the Kid drops back. Lil A trying to hold on, but Lil Payne, a lot of Lils. That's not a tongue twister at all. Lily the Kane, Lil A, and Lily the Kid.
And it looks like we have an injury timeout called. That is number 90.
Lil A
for Tampa, a Team USA alternate, one of the stalwarts and stars for the Tampa Tantrums. And we noticed that she's getting immediate attention from the medics here at ECDX. We want to thank you for tuning in to WFTDA-TV. You are watching all the action from ECDX 2013. Little A is being helped to her feet right now, and that is certainly good to see. Bulldog may have gotten the wind knocked out of her, but a skater with the pedigree of Little A is not going to go quietly out of a game like this.
Okay, well, we've seen nothing but scrappiness, even from the tiniest skaters from Tampa. Now, that's not to say they're all tiny. Blackjack, one of the largest skaters on the track, has been making her presence felt throughout the game. But Lil A, she is one tough cookie. I wouldn't be surprised if we see her back in just a couple of jams. But technically, I believe the jam was called off due to that injury. So the technical rule is she cannot return to the game for the next three jams. So even though you might not see her in the next three jams, doesn't mean she is out. A little bit breaker jamming for Tampa Bay in the paint against a Flying King jamming for Boston. And she fights her way past, but right behind her a little bit. And both jammers now racing around. We haven't seen a jammer horse race like this. And, of course, Flying King calling off the jam. Boston just wanting to ride the clock.
41-point lead, and about like that is this is a pretty impressive advantage. And Boston, as we said at the beginning, they are about discipline and they are about control. And they are a good front-running team. Tampa, with that wide-out style, though, can make things happen in a hurry, Bulldog. And that's what the ladies in pink are hoping to do right now.
Smooth operator. Haven't seen her jam out. Get creamed by a big shoulder check from former 43 Ginger Kid of Boston. And there's Space Invader fighting at the front of the pack. But Lily the Kid almost holding her back, but a little spin move, and Space Invader able to sneak past. 101. I think she was actually sent into the spin by Space Invader. Give credit where credit is due. But Smooth Operator also on a scoring pass. Space Invader leaping across the infield, manages to land it, stick the landing, which is necessary. But it looks like Smooth Operator matching those points, 4-4.
It's a 4-4 wash, like you said. Boston on 153 now. Tampa at 112, and Tampa getting their jammer through for profit right there. Need to start doing a better job of that, though. The ladies in pink have not picked up lead jam yet in this second period. We've got 15 minutes and some change gone by, and Boston has just figured it out. They are springing their jammers, and a little pain. There you go, Bulldog.
But right behind her, Breezy, number 22. So Tampa might be figuring some things out themselves. They managed to get their jammer out two times in a row. And Lil Payne has forced to call off the jam as Breezy's right behind her. So 153 to Boston, 112 for Tampa. Just over 14 minutes left in the game.
This is Max the Axe and Bulldog with the play-by-play. You are watching WFTDA.TV, and if you have any questions or any comments or you just want to say hi, hit us up at #talk2WFTDA.
Little bit breaker, number 365, jamming for Tampa against number 1111, Maya Mangalyu. But this time, little bit breaker, able to sneak her way past Lois Carmen, Dominator, and gets lead jammer for Tampa. The first time in a while, Max. But Maya Mangalyu at the front bashes her way through the two wall of Lil A back in the action, and Lily the Kid. So Maya Mangalyu coming around, and little bit breaker. How many Lils can there be on these teams? But a little bit breaker calling off the jam.
Well, smart play for Tampa, but they wanted more out of that one. Getting lead is one thing. They got to build on that now. You know, you're at this point in about, there's 13 minutes left. You have to take everything moment by moment. It's not just jam by jam. It's jam start by jam start. It's adjustment by adjustment. One of the good adjustments Lil Breaker made right there is taking that inside route. The inside route seems to be open against this Boston defense.
All right, and for Boston, it's Lil Flying King against Lil Apollo Anna. No, they're not Lils. Apollo Anna jamming for Tampa. Knocked to the outside by Bad Person, number 55 for Boston. Up front, it is Flying King just outracing Pupcake and Betty Krueger to get out for lead jammer for Boston. So once again, Boston so far dominating the second half almost entirely. Tampa has been struggling so far, so dominant in the first half. But there goes Apollo Anna finally getting out for her initial pass. But Flying King on her first scoring pass, knocked to the infield by Pupcake, and has to recycle, opts to call off the jam as Apollo Anna of Tampa Bay almost into the pack.
Apollo Anna forcing the call. That's 2 points for Boston. That takes them up to 155-112. Ginger Kid, one of the big-time blockers. She's really important to this Boston team. Has just picked up her fourth personal now, Bulldog. So that could affect how Boston looks at these final 11:30 minutes in this bout.
Smooth operator jamming for Tampa. Dodges around Shayna Nestor and gets out of the pack. Gets past the Boston defense. Lil Payne jamming for Boston. Gets knocked out of bounds by Lunch Lady. Has to recycle all the way back to turn two as the smooth operator gets through the pack. Completes her first scoring pass for 5 points. So looking strong so far in this jam. Lil Payne struggling to get out. Stuck behind Lunch Lady. Driven to the back of the pack as a smooth operator weaves her way through. Gets past Shayna Nestor. Shayna Nestor was all by herself up front. But Crazy Duke's now moving to join her. But that's two scoring passes, two grand slams. But Lil Payne moving into scoring position. But smooth operator calling off the jam from flat on her stomach. No score on those last scoring passes.
She called it off just in time, Bulldog. Crazy Dukes taking some crazy shots during that last jam. But, boy, Tampa had the answer. They sped up the pack and shows that they're willing to play a couple of different styles. We've seen them play a little slower earlier in the bout, and now that actually may be their strong suit as we're getting down to crunch time. 155-122 in favor of Boston.
Space Invader up to the front. Blackjack has position on her, backed up by Laren Kill, but Space Invader dodges around. Is it Breezy jamming for Tampa Bay? Manages to find an opening. Bashes her way past Haley Contagious and Lois Carmen Dominator, but here comes Space Invader jammer for Boston into the back, around the outside of Laren Kill. Betty Krueger knocks her out of bounds, but Space Invader is going to call it off.
3 more points for Boston. They are content to play jam by jam right now. 158-122. We are under 10 minutes in this bout. And game, again, as we said, the last time these two teams played, neither team scored 100 points. So they've opened it up a little bit right now. But it has been close. And these teams are ranked 24 and 26 for a reason. The rankings do work from what we've seen here today. We've got a timeout called on the track by Boston.
That's right. And looks like Shark Week sitting in the penalty box for Boston. So the next jam, we will start out 4-on-3 back advantage for Tampa. But Tampa really needing some momentum, trying to catch up to Boston, trying to reproduce the results that they got in the first half. Boston was reeling for most of that first half, but they came back strong, finishing the first half only 1 point behind. But now Tampa in the same situation pretty much that Boston was in for most of the first half.
Yeah, and Boston continues to pile up the penalties. We've got Haley Contagious with 3, Anorexia with 3, Maya Mangalieu with 4, Vixen DeHitchius picked up her 4th, Shark Week, another important skater for Boston, with 3, Betty Krueger has 4 for Tampa, Lily the Kid has 4 for Tampa as well. Penalties, well, with 9 minutes 21 seconds right now, you got to say those skaters with 4 still have one more that they can give, but that's about it.
A little bit breaker number 365 jamming for Tampa against 1-1-1-1. Maya Mangalieu racing to the front of the pack. Lil A and Lily the Kid holding her back, but Lil A going to the penalty box now, and Maya Mangalieu making short work of Lily the Kid. Claims lead jammer for Boston. Little bit breaker, dodging to the inside, but gets cut off by Dixie Kicks of Boston. Now around the outside, stumbles over Vixen DeHitchia, and now hits the deck as Maya Mangalieu on a scoring pass, struggling against Lunch Lady and Lily the Kid. Up to the front, gets around Lunch Lady. Lily the Kid sees she's too far forward and gives up the chase. And so that's a completed the scoring pass. 5 points for Boston's Maya Mangalieu, but a little bit breaker getting out of the pack as well.
And the play getting a little bit dodgy there in that last jam. Both of these teams have put solid efforts in all weekend long. Now, tournament teams have to get ready for tournament play, and 2 games in one day is something that just you're going to find in the WFTDA regional playoffs and in the championships, at least the first day. So this is a good warm-up for both of these teams. You know, 2 games in 24 hours is difficult to do, but I think you're seeing a little bit of the effects of that right now, Bulldog.
Tampa Bay fielding Apollo Anna on the jammer line. Boston opting for Flying King. Tampa 41 points behind, but Flying King up to the front, fighting the 3 while leaps over a fallen Blackjack, and Betty Krueger trying to hold on, but Flying King gets out of there. She is lead jammer. Apollo Anna forced to recycle to the behind Shayna Nestor, and now that 3 while driven to the outside by Shayna Nestor again, and here comes Flying King on her first scoring pass, held up by Pupcake. But dodges around Pupcake, gets around Betty Krueger, and Blackjack completes a scoring pass for a grand slam. Apollo Anna still on her initial pass, and now just dodging back and forth, almost stationary in the back and driven out of bounds by Ginger Kid. Has to recycle a bit as Flying King on a second scoring pass behind Betty Krueger, but dodges to the inside and gets through.
Hi, an unbelievable jammer takedown there by Betty Krueger, and that allows Flying King to hit the pack again. Boston is putting the foot down, the hammer to the metal, the pedal on the floor, and all the other mixed metaphors that I could possibly come up with for fast going. And this looks to be a 25-point jam, Bulldog. With 6 minutes 30 seconds left, a 50-point lead for Boston looks pretty secure.
There was a jammer star pass. Apollo Anna opting to pass the star to Lil A, but Lil A did get out of the pack, but was right behind Flying King. Flying King calling off the jam before Lil A could put any points on the board for Tampa.
And stepping up to the line is Lil Payne for Boston. She is one of the players that Boston depends on in situations like this to just hold on, hold steady, keep on the track. Really, that's about all Boston needs to do right now with this lead and their style of play is to hold on, stay on the track, no power jam opportunities. Lil Payne not only does that, but she picks up lead as well, Bulldog.
Getting around Lily the Kid. More smooth operator, the jammer for Tampa, still on her initial scoring pass. And Boston has just come alive in this entire second half. Their defense is just in. They've been dominating the Tampa offense. Smooth Operator still trying to get through her initial pass, but everywhere she goes, she sees Lois Carmen Dominator, Dixie Kicks, and Shark Week holding the line in front of her. Now finally fighting her way through, but Lil Payne on a scoring pass. Oh, she's actually knocked out of bounds and opts to call off the jam. And that's the other half of it. Boston has been so consistent getting lead jammer.
Lil Payne so calm, skating back there, surveying the situation. You know, at this level, you're not going to say that we have a timeout called by Tampa. You're not going to say that either of these teams, one is in better condition than the other, because you know that both of these teams are in good, solid physical condition. You have to be to play roller derby at this level. But the interesting thing that I see is it does appear that Tampa have kind of lost a step in this second period, and it makes me think that even though a tough game against Houston resulted in a win for Boston, the big score by 290 to 215 that Tampa lost to Windy City might actually have taken more out of Tampa than Boston's game against Houston did. Windy City is such a powerhouse team that even to score that 115 points against that team really took a lot out of Tampa. And you can understand it, Bulldog, because if you saw that game, you saw lots of serious hits, and you saw how hard the ladies in pink had to work.
That's right, Max. Thank you very much. And we've got number 22, Breezy, lining up for Tampa Bay against number 1978, Space Invader, for Boston. And by the way, if you had those new numbers up, it's exactly 2,000. But we've got Breezy, which means nothing. We've got Space Invader up to the front. Blackjack and Betty Krueger are unable to stop her, and she is lead jammer once again for Boston. That has been the pattern of the second half. Space Invader on a scoring pass, runs into Laren Kill and dodges around her fairly easily. Only that one skater making contact, and it's a grand slam. But now Breezy getting through the pack, completing her initial pass, but a full lap and a half behind Space Invader, who is on her second scoring pass. Pupkick getting in front of her, muscling her back and forth across the track. Space Invader calling off the jam before Breezy can make contact.
And Boston had their four wall all set up in the back. And, you know, at this point, Boston obviously controlling the pace of play. Tampa was doing that earlier, as we saw. Boston is content with 4 minutes left to just simply hold on, let the clock be their friend. The penalties have really, continued to be controlled for Boston. Vixen to hit you has five now, but those have been five basically smart penalties. Back to the action, Bulldog.
Little bit breaker, fighting her way almost through the pack, but gets knocked to the inside. Maya Mangley already through the pack, and lead jammer coming up on the back of the pack. Hits the pack on her first scoring pass. Little bit breaker, getting muscled out of bounds by Shark Week and has to recycle again. Very carefully. Both jammers recycling right now. Maya Mangleyu, though, on her scoring pass. First scoring pass. Lil A at the back of the pack and forces her to wide. But Maya Mangleyu, fighting her way forward, still has that three wall. Tic Tac Tony, Lily the Kid, and now Lil A. Lily the Kid and Lil A forcing her to the infield. She steps out of bounds, but no one gets behind her. So she steps right back in. Maya Mangleyu now one on one with Lil A. Oh, gets knocked to the ground by Lil A. And Lil A manages to stay in front of her. But this time, Maya Mangleyu able to pirouette around her. Lil A makes an effort to try and reel her back in, but Maya Mangleyu skating off with a grand slam. Little bit breaker coming around the outside. The Boston pack has been decimated by penalties, so now Tampa Bay dominating in the pack right now, and Maya Mangleyu having a lot more trouble this time getting through the pack. She had a lot of trouble last time, though, not to take it away, but Lily the Kid and Lil A at the front of the pack, double-teaming Maya Mangleyu as Little Bit Breaker breezes through the pack and is looking to match some points, 4 points. And 3 points, though, as the jam ends for Maya Mangleyu.
Maya Mangleyu was showing the hard work that she put in on that scoring pass. She kind of had her head down a little bit and did let the Tampa jammer to get by for a couple of points. An uncharacteristic Boston play right there, but she got her moment of clarity and called off the jam. It's 197-126 now in favor of Boston.
And we haven't seen PH Diesel jam in a while, but there she is. And fights her way to the front, gets around Anorexia, and gets lead jammer for the first time in a while for Tampa.
Breath of fresh air for the Tampa Tantrums.
Low pain getting through the pack finally, but only just before PH Diesel comes in for her first scoring pass. Gets knocked out of bounds by Vixen to Hitcha. And now the Anorexia drops back, forces PH Diesel through. But PH Diesel looking for that wide line, looks over her shoulder, just sees a glimpse of Lil Payne coming up, calls off the jam in time.
Well, that's one of the things I love about roller derby. A lot of sports, if you saw somebody in Tampa's situation, they would not have called off that jam. They would have said, okay, there's a minute left on the period clock, we're just going to let this thing expire. But not in roller derby. The points matter. The points matter for rankings, and Tampa wants to have every opportunity to get as much on the board as possible. They're not going to just say, okay, we're going to give up. It's 197-128 in favor of Boston, but Tampa's not done yet.
101 smooth operator jamming for Tampa against Flying King. Flying King up front, but has three Tampa skaters in front of her. That's Lil A, Lily the Kid, and Tic-Tac-Tony. Tic-Tac-Tony dropping back to bridge. Lily the Kid forcing Flying King out of bounds. She has to recycle, but it's a penalty for smooth operator. That is possibly the end of the game for the Tampa jammer. Now, right now, it is just Boston. Boston's jammer, Flying King, running into Lily the Kid, but Lily the Kid stumbling, and Flying King getting through, and now is lead jammer. Only seconds remaining on the period clock, and now Flying King not even looking at the pack. She's just looking at the period clock, and we will probably see her call off the jam as she was looking the wrong way. Ginger Kid points out the scoreboard over her shoulder, and she calls off the jam, and that is it, Max.
Flying King with a jubilant jam call-off right there. Big win for Boston. It was in doubt at the beginning of this game. Pinchy McYou-Know-What, the Boston mascot, was probably having a little, I don't know whether lobsters even have hearts, but he was probably having a little palpitation in that first 5 or 10 minutes of the game. Tampa came out very strong, very defensive-oriented, and boy, Boston just couldn't buy a lead jam for the first 5 minutes of this bout. But in the second period, it was just the opposite. Boston owned lead jam Bulldog. Tampa just was having a very difficult time. As I said at one point, the outside track was working for Tampa in the first period, but it simply wasn't there in the second period. And Tampa had so much trouble just getting through the pack on the initial pass that Boston was able to take control of this bout. A 197-128 result here, and that's going to even the series right now. Tampa had won the first time these two teams met by a score of 86-80, and you see the bridge of respect there being built by the Boston Massacre as Tampa takes their consolation lap as well.